Hello everyone, my name is Luis Rodriguez, and for Bean Architecture today I want to introduce the course How to Learn Revit Faster. In this video I want to show the practical stuff that you need to know before you get inside of Revit. But you see, you have this image in your screen and you can see that Revit is a software that includes feature for architectural map and structural design and construction. Revit supports a multidiscipline collaborative design process. This is an important software right now in the AEC industry. Now, before you learn anything software, you need to know that there is a knowledge curve. For this example, I put the implementation curve, but it's the same for the knowledge curve. Maybe you, at this time, you use AutoCAD or another software, but if you feel that, are you okay with your work? But if you want to use another software, for example, Revit, you need to know that there is a curve implementation about the knowledge that you need to pass about that. And maybe you think that the implementation curve is upper always, but now the reality is you have some workload tension and change about this workload, and it depends on you what type of learning that you need to know to reduce this uncertainty about the workload. For this example, I recommend you the paid course and with the best teacher that you can have. Now that you know to this one, maybe I can show, you this particular video about the example using AutoCAD and versus Revit about the creation of a little workflow in some basic house, and maybe you see before in internet, and you can see things bit faster if you want to create a floor plan. If you see there is one person that they know how to use these two software, the AutoCAD and Revit, and he has the compound and the family, and this is like the faster way that you can create any element that you want. And for this example, this creating in the speed faster, that you can see how many times does he need to create a simple plan, floor plan. For example, you see that with Revit, it takes 15, almost 16 minutes. And with AutoCAD, the same floor plan takes more than 30 minutes. And this is the principal reason that you can change this platform. And if you see for the elevation, it's the same, 5 times faster. For this example, in 80 seconds, you can create an elevation with all the information about the elements because Revit creates a 3D model parametric that you can take a picture and see in elevation, in section, or in callout. And you can see all these elements like modeling. Now, the principal stuff is that you have to model correctly, because the section, it shows you the elements that you create. You can see a lot of difference between this workflow. Like I say, there is a different option that you can do in Revit is a multidisciplinary software that you can modeling like Revit, plumbing, electrical, and map elements. And for this type, you have the structural elements too that you can model in like rebar, steel column, composite elements. And for the another thing, you can create a fake interior architectural some pipeline. And another thing that I like too much from Revit is the interoperability that he has. For this example, we have a lot of software about Autodesk that you can interoperability with that, and you had more than 3 million of adding some plugin application for the Autodesk. And another, you have the external software has the plugin for the interoperability. We have the Industry Foundation class, the IAPC, that is a extension that you can share with any software related with BIM. And it's like the BIM standard that you can share information about that. At the moment, it's not so well, but there is some software that there are great, or they have the best interoperability with this file, and I recommend you for another. For example, Revit is not so good, but you can try with another plugin for interoperability. For example, like the robot, if you are a structural designer, with the CSI, they have their Revit, the CSI Revit X, you can interoperability, and with the Bentley you have the OESM plugin, for example, and at the same you can interoperability with another software like ArchiCAD. There are some particularities that you can do or not do in this software. For example, you can not use another version later. For this example, if you open Revit in 2019, you can open this file in Revit 2018 or 16. This is the software reason, because right now it is using the subscribe version, and you can choose all this software with the new version. That you need to know that is related with the construction. And this is the principal reason that if you are not a construction, maybe it will be more difficult to learn about that. This is a parametric software that is related with objects. For this example, like a wall is related with the height or with the level or something like that. It doesn't that if you modeling in Revit, you do BIM. No, this is a error, a mistake, and you need to know about BIM if you want to use Revit for modeling BIM. And the minimum requirements are bigger from that AutoCAD. For this example, I open this page that they put the minimum requirement about the hardware information. If you want to use Revit in your computer, you have the minimum memory, for example, 4 gigabytes of RAM. This is space free in your disk. And there is more example about that, the upgrade and price. For example, if you modeling a bigger infrastructure, you need to have a better computer if you don't break your model, and if you don't create a standard that your computer can modeling well this element. and you need to spend more money for this particular computer if you use or if you create a large model. Okay, and there is some recommendation about that. The basic recommendation that I want to teach you is that you need to have knowledge, basic knowledge about the construction. And this is because there is a software related with the construction and some Windows and application are related with the with this construction. For example, you can put the foundation after the floor is doesn't correctly. Constructability is the principal reason, and if you want to modeling right, I know that it's some like dummy, but you need to know about read, and this is a particular because when you start learn a software, you need to spend more time and concentration about the process that you do. And for this example and for another software, they are very interactive with the person, and they show you with a warning or the recommendation. But if you don't read this information, you take a lot of mistakes. It's recommend that you have the basis about building information modeling because it is a software related with this methodology. And if in the future you want to work in a big company, you can learn Revit, but if you don't know how to use BIM, maybe it could be difficult for you to obtain a job. The recommendation too is use before a CAD or CAM software, because almost this software are related with that. And if you have the basis about another software, it could be easy for you to learn about this Revit. You need to be conscious about the start this use about the Revit, because the first step is pretty difficult if you don't use any software before, and you will have to spend more time using this particular tool. You need to study about the constructive process, because you can create better modeling, better structure, because you know how to virtual construct the element. And another recommendation about that is that you at least need to know how the sheets are created. What is the information that you need to create a construction document that you can understand the Revit better.